Hey everyone, it's Carissa at Sprinkled with Glitter. Thanks for joining me today. Today, art and card making collide as I combine some Arteza art supplies with my card making supplies to create some beautiful card projects and experiment with some new techniques. And I did want to mention that in the description of this video or over at my blog, you will find a 10% off discount code when you shop at arteza.com or the Arteza UK site as well for my friends across the pond. So here's a look at some of the supplies that Arteza sent me. And some of these supplies you may have seen in card making before, but I tried to kind of pick some supplies as well that I thought maybe you haven't seen in card making before. So I'll be starting out with the Arteza Real Brush Pens. Those are our water-based brush marker, and I'll show you some techniques with that. I'll also be playing with the Arteza Gouache. Now, this is a set of 60 colors of gouache. They come in these tubes. The color range is absolutely fantastic, and I will be talking a little bit later on more specifically about what gouache is, but I kind of just wanted to give you an overview of this set here. And I did want to point out that on the top of this box, you'll see it when I put the lid back on, there is a guide that tells you about the light fastness of each color as well as the opacity of each color. So be sure that you check that out on the top of the gouache. It's a nice little guide there. Now, another product that I thought would be fun to play with in card making is the Arteza Mica Powders. Now, this is a set of 35 different mica powders here. These come in a larger set also of 60 colors, but this is a huge range of colors here. And mica powders are basically kind of like a pigment powder that has a really like pearly or shimmery finish to it. So I'm just kind of shaking these around, checking out the colors. Now these are cosmetic grade, and I'm gonna tell you how I'm gonna take care of those in just a bit. But basically you can use them in cosmetics as well as like on bath bombs and stuff. So I'm gonna preserve their sterility. Later on in the video, you'll see me do that. Now, next up is the Arteza vinyl. This is self-adhesive vinyl, but it's holographic vinyl. And I wanted to show you a couple of things that you could do with this vinyl in card making. It comes in a beautiful selection of colors here. And I mean, this stuff shines like the sun. It is so it is so beautiful. I absolutely love all the different colors, and I'm going to show you how to stamp on this a little bit later on in the video. Now, in addition to all of the art supplies and that sort of thing, Arteza also has some different canvases, easels, adhesives, so be sure to check it out. I was really surprised at the range of products that Arteza offers. So let's get started with the Real Brush Pens from Arteza. This is the set of 48. You can see there's a lot of beautiful colors. I do not know exactly how much ink comes in each pen, and how long they're gonna last is gonna depend on how much you use them. So it's kind of impossible to tell how much each of these will last, but they have a really flexible Real Brush nib on them. So it's a nylon brush. They also come with this water brush that you can fill with water. Now, I am going to use these on some smooth Bristol cardstock, and I'm using a few different colors here, starting out with this really beautiful pink. I'm going to bring in a couple of different yellows here, one that's a little more orange and one that's a little bit brighter yellow. And I'm just scribbling these down onto my smooth Bristol cardstock. I'm going to finish off with a really beautiful teal blue color. Now, this is a very simple watercolor technique that you can do with these Real Brush Pens. They are a water-based ink, so they move really well when they are exposed to a little bit of water. I'm just using my water brush here to kind of mix those colors together and create a really quick rainbow watercolor background. Now you're gonna see that I only used a few of these colors, but I'm getting the whole rainbow worth here. And in order to add just a little bit of purple to this, I added a little bit more of that pink to the bottom where that blue or that teal will meet it. And that gave me a little bit of purple along the bottom. Now these Real Brush Pens are also great for creating watercolor effects on your stamped images. So I'm just stamping a lemon here. I'm using a couple of different shades of yellow and a couple of different shades of green to get some variation. Now you can get some variation with just one color by adding a lot of water to it, But this is going to help me build up those shadows even more by using a couple of different shades of each of these colors here. So between each of these colors, I'm just kind of wiping off my water brush onto a paper towel to kind of clean it up so I don't contaminate the yellow with the green or the green with the yellow. So that's a quick way to create watercolor effects on your stamped images. Now, another way that you can use these real brush pens is that you can scribble them onto a slick surface and then pick them up with your water brush. I especially like to do this when I want to create a custom color. And I kind of wanted something more coral here. So I'm taking an orange and a pink marker and kind of blending them together on this acrylic block. And then I'm picking up that color with my water brush and just, I'm going to use that to color in these floral images that I have stamped or these blossom images. And when I first started out, I started out with kind of equal parts orange and pink, and I didn't quite have the color I wanted. So I added a little bit more pink into that mixture. And I was able to create a custom color to watercolor these little blossoms here. Now I'm gonna set these aside and let them dry. I will come back to them to create some card projects in just a bit, but we're gonna continue our exploration of these art products from Arteza with our gouache. And I wanted to pull out all of the trays here so you could see the range of colors. And I'm going to pull out a few that I think will mix well or kind of coordinate well back to that rainbow that I created earlier. I have to mention there's one color in here called peach, and the label on it looks really mauve, but the color is absolute perfection. And you're gonna see me use quite a bit of that here in today's projects. I'm just taking these tubes of gouache and I'm just kind of squirting a little bit out onto this watercolor media mat. This is the peach color that I was talking about. The label on it is really mauve looking, and most of the colors kind of match really well to the label that's on the outside of the tube, but this one I found it didn't really coordinate, but that's okay because I absolutely love the color that's inside. Now I'm just squeezing these out, and the best way that I'm not professionally art trained, but the best way that I can describe a gouache in my layman's terms is that it's something between like an acrylic paint and a watercolor. So it's a little bit more opaque than a watercolor is, and it can water down with water. So you can create a more translucent effect by adding water. But it is more opaque than a watercolor. It has kind of an opaque property to it. So in stamper's terms, it might be something that's kind of between a dye-based ink and a pigment ink. Maybe that makes a little bit of sense to you. And here I'm just kind of painting these onto some watercolor cardstock and I'm just testing them out. Now, I really never meant for this to be anything other than just me scribbling some of these gouaches down onto this watercolor cardstock. But later on, I go back to this and I actually create an abstract style card with this piece of cardstock that I just scribbled some gouache on. Now, I wanted to show you the opacity of gouache because at this point, they may seem a little bit like watercolor to you. So I'm going to stamp this big, beautiful floral image onto this watercolor cardstock, and I'm going to go right over it with some of this gouache. Now, this is the peach gouache that I absolutely fell in love with. This color is perfection. In fact, I've been on the hunt for a nail polish this color for forever. So I'm just going to go over, and I'm going to quickly add some gouache over the stamped image, and I think when I hold this up to the camera, you're really going to see how that gouache kind of goes over those black lines and really mutes that black back. You won't get the same effect when you're using a watercolor. It will kind of wash out and go over those black lines, and those black lines will stay a little bit brighter and bolder. But with a gouache, it's definitely going to kind of be more opaque. So when you go over the black lines with it, it's going to mute them or dull them back. Now you can definitely create some watercolor wash effects on backgrounds with this, and you can definitely use it to color or paint in your stamped images. You just want to make sure that you're not going over the tops of those lines or you're going to really dull them back. Now, the cool thing that you can do with gouache is go on to a darker color cardstock. So I'm going on to a craft colored cardstock here with a little bit of this peach gouache. It's watered down just a little bit, so it's slightly translucent. It's not completely opaque. If you want it to be more opaque, remember you're going to add less water to it. So, and if you want it to stay opaque, but you want it to be lighter, you can always mix it with the white gouache as well. So that's a couple of different ways that you can use that. But you're going to see here, I went onto this craft colored cardstock with that peach that was a little bit watered down, and I was still able to maintain that peach color on top of that darker cardstock. So this is something that gouache can do that watercolor cannot do. So I'm going to stamp right over the top of this. You can definitely, with the right ink, stamp right over the top of this gouache. I'm using the Gina K Obsidian Amalgam ink here. And you can add some colors over the top of that, but keep in mind, gouache is going to activate gouache. So you may get a little mix of colors if you try to go over the top of it. Now, here is a technique that a lot of people like to do with gouache, and that is the splatter. And I have to tell you, I just added a little bit of the titanium white gouache onto my acrylic block, watered it down a little bit, and flicked it on with a paintbrush. This actually inflicted physical pain for me, but I wanted to show you the technique. And the reason that it is so painful to me is because I was like making a mess on purpose, and it was really hard for me to do, but I wanted to show you that technique as well. Now let's have a look at these Arteza mica powders here. I am going to start by stamping an image onto some white cardstock using a little bit of Versamark ink. Now this is typically the ink that I will use for embossing. And I wanted to show you that these come sealed up so they're not gonna make a mess on the way to you. And it also comes with this really tiny little spoon. And this spoon is perfect for pulling out a little bit of this mica powder. Now I wanted to show you this mica powder, a little goes a really long way. So that spoon is plenty big. You just wanna take the tiniest amount of this mica powder, and you can use a fluffy brush. I'm actually using an eyeshadow brush for this, a fluffy brush, and just kind of patting it and swiping it over the top of this stamped image. And you're gonna see that it leaves me with this really beautiful kind of chalky but shimmery pearly finish over this stamped image. Now, once I have the mica powder applied, I'm just gonna take a dry microfiber cloth and wipe away the excess, and I had no problem with this really coming off. You may see a tiny bit on my finger here, but for the most part, this set into place with no problem with that Versamark ink. Now, this comes in a range of really beautiful colors, and I wanted to play with a few of these colors here, so I'm gonna grab a couple more, and I'm just using that little spoon to put them onto a piece of acrylic, just something easy that I can pick them up off of with that fluffy brush. And you're gonna see really how little I used of each of these powders. I held it up to the camera there so you could really see. But all of these powders have a little bit of a unique property to them. They're kind of iridescent. Some of them are very iridescent. They go on to this ink really well, and they actually go on to a more delicate stamped image really well, and I'll show you that in just a bit. I think this one's really beautiful. It's kind of white, but it has this iridescent shimmer to it. And when I have anything shimmery at all, I can hardly stand not putting it on my skin. And I figured this was safe because these are cosmetic grade, and so you can use them in things like eyeshadows and lip glosses, or on bath bombs if you're into that kind of thing. And so when I get these mica powders out of their jars, I'm being really careful that I keep my spoon clean and that I don't go into them with this brush that I'm using on all of my projects here, because I don't really want to contaminate them. If I want to use them for bath bombs or something like that later on, I can definitely do that. Now, I am no expert on bath bomb making. I have made them in the past and it was really fun. So I thought I would just kind of preserve the cleanliness of these mica powders by using that spoon so that if I did want to use them on something like that in the future, I can. Now, I wanted to show you these on a more delicate stamped image, like a sentiment. And so I'm just stamping the sentiment onto this Nina Solar White cardstock here and putting that mica powder over the top. And you're going to see that this actually works really well. So it gives you a really beautiful shiny gold image. It has no loft to it or no rays like an embossing powder would, but it has a whole lot of shimmer and shine to it, so it's absolutely beautiful. Now, because the mica powders are a pigment powder, they go on to dark cardstock really well. I'm just going to show you that briefly here. I've stamped a couple of images here, including that sentiment and that heart, onto this black cardstock. And I am just using that fluffy brush again to apply the mica powders. And you're going to see they show up really well on dark cardstock as well as that lighter colored cardstock. So you can use these on dark or light cardstock. Now, another thing that mica powders are really good for is kind of coloring or adding color and shimmer to some of the different mediums that you may already have in your craft room. So one of those might be some clear glitter drops or something that you have, or a texture paste, or even some of that white gouache that I showed you earlier. The sky is really the limit, so this is really going to just give you an opportunity to take some of those mediums that you may already have in your craft room and kind of add a little bit of color and maybe a little bit more shimmer to them as well. Now let's jump into the Arteza Holographic self-adhesive vinyl, and I have the pack of 16 here. You can see all the beautiful colors, and when I tilt them in the light, you can see those really beautiful hollow effects. Now I want to mention there are instructions for using this on the back of the package, but I'm going to use it with my card making supplies today, so with some stamps and dies. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start out by cutting this down so it will fit through my die cut machine. Now, this is absolutely something that you can use with a digital die cutter, but I'm going to show you that you can use it with your traditional dies as well. So I'm just taking this mermaid tail die here. I'm going to run it through my Gemini Junior, which is the traditional die cut machine that I use most often. This will also work in something like your Spellbinders Platinum 6. And you can see this cut through that vinyl absolutely beautifully. Now, vinyl is a slick surface, but you can stamp on it. And I am using some Stazon Jet Black ink. My Stazon pad really needs to be re-inked right now. So you're going to see that I have some holes in my stamping, but that's really because my pad needs to be re-inked. But I can just stamp right on that vinyl, and that's going to give me a beautiful stamped image with that holographic vinyl in the background. Now, I thought I'd quickly show you another example of just stamping and die cutting this holographic self-adhesive vinyl. And this is great for putting on things like your water bottle or a cell phone case, but you can also apply this vinyl to some plain white cardstock and die cut it and use it on your card projects as well. So just because it's vinyl, and sometimes we think of applying it to glass or frames or our water bottle, it doesn't mean that you can't use it in your card making projects as well. So now that we've kind of explored these products a little bit, I'm going to create some cards using some of the elements that I created earlier and then using some new pieces as well. So once again, I am taking some craft cardstock. This is actually a mixed media craft cardstock, so it's gonna hold up to the water a little bit better. And I'm gonna use some of that, of course, peach gouache, to create a little bit of a wash on the background of this card. And I have gone ahead and die cut that lemon and the blossoms that I watercolored earlier using the Arteza Real Brush pins. And I am going to apply those onto this card. And I am using the Arteza foam adhesive today. I have to tell you, this foam adhesive, it was a little bit difficult to get the backer off of it. And I did have to use scissors to cut it. You cannot tear it. But as far as adhesive properties go, it sticks really well. Now I wanted to add a little bit more texture to this background. So I'm taking a little stripe stamp here. I'm going to stamp it right on top of that gouache wash that I created on this craft cardstock. And I'm using some Versamark ink for that. And I'm going to apply some of this pearly white powder right over the top of that. And it's just going to kind of give a little bit of a shimmer to the background, it's going to add that really mixed media effect where you kind of layer up different mediums and different textures. And so I'm just going to apply that on there with my fluffy brush. I'll wipe away the excess with a microfiber cloth. And I am going to add, you guessed it, some little bit of splatter to this. Now, I have to tell you, once again, very hard for me to do because for a couple of reasons. Number one, I'm making a mess. But also, there is so little control over the splatter that it just kind of makes my very type A personality kind of cringe a little bit. So you just kind of have to go with it, and that's what I'm doing today. Now, I finished this card off by creating a stamped sentiment onto some vellum and applying that onto my card front. I applied my card front onto an A2 top folding card base with some more of that Arteza foam adhesive, and I finished it off with a little bit of black and white baker's twine at the top. And you can see this is my finished card project. Absolutely adorable and featuring several of those different art products from Arteza. Now, because that peach colored gouache is so absolutely perfect, I decided to go ahead and create another background. It's already on my palette, so I can create this background using some more of that peach gouache. I'm changing the intensity of the color by adding more water to it. So it's going to start darker at the top. It's going to get a little bit more light and watercolory towards the bottom. And all I'm doing to create that effect is adding more water. So by adding more water to the gouache, it's going to become more watercolor-like and more translucent. If you want it to stay more opaque, you can use it straight or with just a damp brush. But if you want it to stay opaque and you want it lighter, you can just add a little bit of white gouache to your original color and you will get a completely different color. Now, I did this on some watercolor cardstock and I am going to go ahead and heat set that, make sure it's completely dry. I'm going to treat it with my powder tool and I am going to white heat emboss this floral image over the top of it. So I'm just stamping it with some Versamark ink and then I'm adding some white embossing powder and I will heat set that. Now, in order to add a little bit more depth and dimension to these flowers, once this is heat set, I'm gonna go into that peach gouache again. I've added a little bit more white gouache to it, so it's a little bit lighter than my background. And I'm just kind of flicking this in and adding some different highs and lows to this. So it's gonna just make that floral image stand out a little bit more. And at the end, I did go around the edge of the embossing and kind of add a little bit more of that lighter gouache around the edge as well. Now, I'm going to finish this card off by adding just a simple strip of black and white striped pattern paper, a heat emboss sentiment, and then I added just a little couple strips of some gold polka dot washi tape. This gives it kind of that mixed media effect. I am using, by the way, some foam adhesive to adhere my heat emboss sentiment strip to the front of this card as well. So you can see this is the finished project. You can see how I have those highlighted areas in my floral image. It's absolutely beautiful and so easy to do. So let's move on to our final card project that I'm going to show you today. There's actually one more at the end of this video that you can see photos of, but I didn't actually film it. I have taken a Hooray die and I've just die cut that holographic vinyl using my regular old die. And I'm using a regular die cutting sandwich when I die cut this holographic vinyl. I'm just gonna remove the backer of the self-adhesive vinyl and apply this right onto a strip of vellum. This is really easy to do, and that vinyl can be a little bit flimsy when you're handling it, but it's not super delicate. It won't rip really easily. So I'm going to end up applying this at an angle over that watercolor background that I created earlier using the Arteza Real Brush Pens. But before I adhere that, I am going to add a little bit more shimmer and texture to this background, just like I did on the first card. So I've stamped a patterned stamp onto my card front, and I'm adding a little bit of that mica powder. And then I will add my sentiment strip at a diagonal right over the top of that using a little foam adhesive, and then I just added some sequins. Now, here's the final card for today, and I didn't actually film this one because I really hadn't planned on making a card out of it, but I just took that little card front that I created by scribbling some gouache on it and added a few die cuts over the top and a heat embossed sentiment, and that finished off that card. So here's a look at all of the card projects that I created today using these Arteza art supplies. It is really fun to experiment with different supplies, and I had a great time kind of experimenting. I know my daughter, she is actually an artist. She prefers acrylic paints. She is a big fan of the Arteza products. She has used their canvases in the past and their acrylic paints, and she cannot wait to get her hands on more of their acrylic paints as well. As always, I will have links to the featured products used in these projects in the description at YouTube, so be sure you check there, or you can head on over to my blog at sprinkledwithglitter.com. I'll have that linked below. Over there, you'll find more still shots, more information, and a complete list of supplies. And don't forget to check the description box here or over at my blog for the discount code that I will have for you to use at arteza.com. I will also have the UK Arteza linked for my friends across the pond. As always, thanks for stopping by and hanging out with me today. I hope you enjoyed these projects. If you did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on the notifications so you won't miss any of my paper crafting and card making video tutorials. Once again, thanks for watching and stopping by, and until next time, I hope you have a fabulous day. Hey, thanks for sticking around to the very end. You know, if you've made it this far, you are one of my favorites. To subscribe to my channel, go ahead and click the button on the left side of the screen. And here's a couple more video tutorials I thought you might enjoy.